There we go. Hey, everybody. I was going to do this last night when I streamed. I decided against it because there was another game I wanted to play, so I'm going to do this today. And we are getting to December, which means we are going to be doing the go-home show to our second really huge event, and that's End of the Road. Which I never got around to. I never got around to, I never got around to making a logo for it, so I'm just kind of, like, shrugging my shoulders, like, eh, what are you going to do? I never redid an Infamous one either. I'll probably do that before next stream, and then try to figure out a name for the spring show in March. Okay. So, I haven't really thought about this too much. But I know if I'm making some decent profit, which I seem to be doing at a pretty good rate now that I make actual ticket sale money, I can actually kind of start factoring that into how much money I make on a regular basis. Now, I guess it's a little bit different because I made about maybe $1,500 more than I normally do in sponsorship money, but I'm going to try to start factoring that in the fact that I should try to get some nicer stuff, because at this point, I got F plus importance, but I'm up to E minus in popularity. And if I do E plus importance, which could easily mean at least a D minus, maybe even a D when I get there. I'm going to try to get some nice stuff here at the time. And I remember talking about this at the beginning, and that was possibly bringing in Christopher Daniels as like a big star, and then also changing out Jake Roberts with, or changing out Brian Clark with Jake Roberts. And I think that'll probably help out. Not to mention, I don't know if he could be a road agent and a color commentator. I really don't know. But, $1,380 a month is officially what he's asking for, which is, I did say right before I recorded, which is why you'll probably see a lot of GIFs and pictures. And if anyone in the chat, I accept any and all I accept any and all pictures and gifts of Konosuba right now. Okay, so yeah, Brian Clark was doing $670 per show. And I was going to be doing, okay. So if I remember that right, since I do two shows a month, it'd be an extra $1,400, which basically gets cut in half by the fact that after this one should be okay. God damn it. The only thing I don't like about that is that she clearly is not that, clearly is not that stacked. It's really amazing to me to find out just how many people like are just like, why would you do that? Flat is justice. Oh man. Okay, so I'm gonna go spending my money and bringing people in. Jake Roberts is for sure the first guy. Okay, how much is Christopher Daniels? I forget how much. He was $1,200. Okay, so what happens is when Mio Shirai is gone, it's going to be $750 a show. So I'm going to get that back. So we're probably talking an extra $2,000 or so a month by bringing in Christopher Daniels probably once a month, and then having Jake Roberts instead of Brian Clark. So, man, I guess I could take that hit. It is one of those things. I'm not 100% sure, but yeah. You're watching a Sunday Girls Championship. Like I said, I'm on Siri earlier. Nice. All right. I guess we'll look into bringing in Christopher Daniels. Due to my declining physical abilities, I definitely need a reduced schedule. You're going to have to limit me to major TV shows and above. I don't know if that's going to allow me to actually use him. I got to be honest. I don't know if that means, because I don't do major TV shows and above. I do medium house shows, but I don't know if that's going to allow me to actually use him. I may have to give up on him. Maybe that means he won't work B-shows, but that's all we do is B-shows. They're all medium-sized shows. I don't know if the major TV shows and above is... Because, like, major TV shows and above is basically any televised show and then pay-per-views. So, yeah, major TV shows and above. Like, oh, man. I may have to give up on Christopher Daniels just because of this. A show versus B show, Raw SmackDown relationship. But that's the thing. I don't know if that's going to translate to... You can't have a B show until you get a certain level anyway. Yeah, I'm just going to give up on Christopher Daniels for right now because it's just not worth it right now. I'm too small to have any sort of major show, so... I don't know if there's other people to bring in. I just realized... who is it? She's technically not retired yet in this either. Huh. That's sad. So, I do want to bring in, like, one... I do really want to bring in at least one really good... star, basically. Someone that I can... let's get rid of all the... Can work in USA status active wrestler. JR's doing a good job commentating. Oh, nice. Well, that's good to know. Alright, so as far as great workers are concerned... I don't know. We're too small for Austin Aries, aren't we? Yep. If I remember right, we're too small for just about everybody. Even Saban. Yeah. Daniels, Richards. I think we're too small for Richards, too. I really want to bring in somebody. Gulak wouldn't be too bad. Petey Williams. How can I be too small for Petey Williams? He's willing to listen to offers. $7.90 a month. Okay. It's good to at least know right this second. Why does it say he's available to hire? Must be like his last month in WWE, but he'll get a new contract, so... Okada is a pay-per-appearance guy. Must be Ambrose's as well. I could always bring in Jack Evans. To be fair, Jack Evans, stat-wise, especially right here in the performance skills, is quite good. I do quite enjoy that. By the way, a C-minus respect and a B-minus psychology puts him almost at the level, road agent-wise, as Brian Clark. So, basics, consistency is good. Selling, safety, athleticism. How much would Jack Evans charge? It's probably like over $1,000. $1,400. Jesus Christ. How are we too small for D.H. Smith? Piss off. How are we... Well, we're too small for Drew Gulak, really? Dude, you wrestle for Chikara and CZW and PW... Like, come on. We're getting to that point. Evans works AAA on the reg, so that would explain his rate. Good point. I tend to forget that he still does work it regularly. Man, I mean, I guess PD kind of works, but like, we're too small for like everybody. We're even too small for Rocky Romero. He doesn't even work New Japan anymore, I don't think. I haven't seen him on Dragon Gate. Daivari's willing to come in. So we got either Daivari or Petey Williams for $7.90 a month. I'd say performance and physical skill wise, Daivari wouldn't be too bad. He's kind of eh. And then skill wise, he's pretty okay. I'd say Daivari might actually be a bigger Sean fucking Daivari. Well, I guess the fact that he's actually in Lucha Underground means that he'd probably have a slightly better time there. So maybe I could bring him in for a couple of appearances. Alright, skill-wise, he's pretty good. Consistency's really nice. Selling safety. All his basics are pretty good. Microphone and charisma's eh. I'll shortlist him, and I'll consider it later. I won't worry about, like, a big star right now. We'll get through the month. We'll get through our first, like, big event, and then we'll figure that out. I was originally going to, like, bring in someone big, and then I'm like, you know what? We'll just leave it alone for right now. I don't know if we've officially had our first Tama Tonga match. I think we have. But not, like, a real, real one. Let me see. Profile, match list. Alright, he had that one beatdown of the Big O, but that's it so far. So yeah, like his first actually big match. Sendai made a contract extension to Kairi Hojo, that's fine. We're going to Monday. Yeah, we didn't get very far. Hopefully Jake Roberts decides to... That'd be nice. Oh! Is this it? Oh! Put me over. Alright, deal extension. That's good. Jake Roberts. Alright, $13.80 in appearance. Complete the contract. And we now have Jake Roberts signed, which means we will now be getting rid of Brian Clark. There we go. Alright. Road agent. Color commentator. I wonder if we can make him officially a road agent, and then he could be the color guy as well. Should be able to work. There we go. Save that. What an interesting announce table that would be, by the way. Introducing Hawkeye Pro Wrestling with your commentating team, Eric Bischoff and Jake Roberts. Can't say that wouldn't be pretty sweet. I don't know how good Paul Burchill is. Yeah, let's not do Paul Burchill. Let's just close that. So that's our announce team, I guess, is Eric Bischoff and Jake Roberts. That's interesting, to say the very least. But yeah, as a road agent, he should be quite good. Oh yeah. B-Respect, A-Psychology. I wonder if this is really going to do well to affect how well the matches go now. I really want to know this. I'm actually kind of excited for the next the next event, just to see. Because, like, okay, so he had a 90 and a 78, if I remember right? What did you have? You had a 90 and a 78 as your two numbers for Road Agent. That's not, if I remember right, Brian Clark was like a 30-something and an 80. It doesn't say officially, but, like, his respect is very strong. I think it was about an 80, 85, but then his, as you could see, that his, it wasn't tremendous. Physical, others, yeah, respect hasn't really changed too much, but if I remember right, it was like a 38 and an 80, so I'm thinking we're going to do a lot better now. So yeah, I'm very excited to see if the matches turn out a lot better, because I know a good road agent will definitely help out a good match, will definitely help out a match. Ah, T-Hawk's the IGF champion. Ice ribbon. Okay, cool, whatever. I should really check real quick, make sure we're still on for Thursday. Cool. We're also technically on for Sunday if I wanted to do a Sunday show. Yeah, we'll just skip to Thursday. Oh. Sorry, I really had to stretch there. All right, email's waiting. Okay. I wonder, okay, there's definitely a way to do this, I believe. Trying to remember. New worker highlights, new worker frequency. It doesn't seem like I'm able to exactly... I know in the email portion somewhere, I'm able to change what comes up as stuff that I need to particularly care about. But that's fine. I'll just keep this up. I hate yawning so much. All right, what happened? And she signed too. Cool. Tonight. All right. Nobody's scheduled, and nobody's scheduled for the big show next week. Alright. So, we are at the next Infamous, which is 19. Caleb Conley, Shane Hollister are the ones with morale issues, so I'm going to see if I can't do something about that. 255 fans expected, so we may very well sell this out tonight. And that would be just awesome if that does manage to work out like that. Because this holds 250 people. So, yeah, I'm all for that. All right. I'm kind of excited to see just how this is going to work out here. Okay, so we need to build our go-home show without spending too much money on people. So I also need to remember what exactly it was that I was kind of building towards. And I know there's a couple of matches. My pre-booking should be... Okay, that number one contendership match, followed by the Big O and Paul Burchill. Okay. So I'm wondering if we should do that. I think that might have been the opening match the last time I did their match. Yeah, so we'll save it for a little bit later. Let's see. I'm going to immediately have... I've got an idea. Let's do... self-promo. Let's do... okay. We're going to do Shane Hollister. Oh, that's right. Since I have him as a road agent, I don't think I could technically add him in. There we go. We're going to take both the scripts off him. Jake Roberts can talk, right? Eh. Not quite how he used to, but that's fine. I understand. Shane is in the ring. Talks about... da-da-da. I got 22. You got 21. I got 22. Talks about title defense. Comes out to announce he is the... oh. Hollister talks about his title defense. Jake the Snake comes out to announce that he is the special ref. And I think that's how I'll work that. Is we'll have Jake Roberts. That's how we're going to introduce Jake Roberts. He's there on the mic, or he's the announcer, but he's going to be the special guest ref. I don't know, something cool. I want to like just give a nice bang into that. Yeah, that big Jake Roberts intro. To be like, oh my god! Okay. So... I should have a match list. This is one of those times I need to pull up, I need to pull up Notepad again so I know what it is I'm trying to book for... if I can find it. There we go. So I know what I'm trying to book for the end of the road. End of the road card. We're definitely doing the Big O versus Tama Tonga. We are doing Mio Shirai versus Dash Chisako for the HPW Women's title. Okay, let's see here. So we got that title match. There's definitely a couple of other ones. Let's see. Have we really... we haven't really addressed the Cody Hall... Tadarius Thomas thing, have we? So we did the impersonation, and then after that, so we will have Cody Hall versus Tidarius Thomas. I'm just kind of putting this outside of the stream here, just so I know what I'm gonna be doing. Okay. What the hell else am I going to be doing? Alright, I feel like we need something for... We definitely need something from Marty Skrull. Actually, I don't even know what our main title match is going to be, because we have a triple threat, and I need to figure out who's actually going to win said triple threat. I'm trying to think.
It seems like it should be Alpha Jr., but... Because he's the only face
right now that could possibly face him. Because Alex Reynolds is a pure heel. And he wouldn't go good as a heel. Or as a face. Caleb Conley wouldn't make a good face. And it's way too early to turn them. Let me see where we're kind of at. Yeah, so the only other face is Mark Sherman, and he's up in the upper mid-card. Everyone else is a mid-carder. So I feel like I've kind of pigeonholed myself into this. Alright, we'll definitely do the blow-off. I think that's how we're going to do this. So, Shane Hollister versus Alpha Noi Jr. One more time. This will be the absolute definite blow-off, because I've been wanting to move away from Alpha Noi Jr. in the main event, because between people like Conley and people like Alex Reynolds, I've just been more into wanting to push either one of these two to try to face him. So we'll do Alpha Noi Jr. for sure. Not quite sure after that. Okay, so based off of how we had this last one here, we're going to do... I'm trying to see here. I've got an idea. I don't know how well it's going to work. Yeah, there's... Okay, how many good faces are there? Okay, Juice Robinson was definitely going to be facing someone in a one-on-one match. Who was he going up against? Was it just the Caleb Conley thing? I feel like there was other stuff that I did with him that was working its way in. Alright, so I think what I'm going to do here... I've got an idea, and I want to put Matt Cage in something as a heel, so he's going to have to face... We're going to put him up against a mid-card face. Let's put him up against... We either got Juice Robinson, Amasis... Man, I kind of remember doing something with Amasis. I can't remember what it was I was... doing per se. Redman takes his frustration out on losing out on Yuma. Amasis has already left. Okay. So that's kind of what I was doing there. So what we were doing Amasis and Joel Redman? Seems about right. That's what I was working towards. Joel Redman. And then we will have try to throw some more guys in here as maybe like a tag team. Juice is gonna need Yeah, we don't really have much anything, so we'll do Juice Robinson and a face of some type that could work. Let's have it be Pete Dunne. Juice Robinson and Pete Dunne versus Caleb Conley and Matt Cage, possibly? How much am I paying Caleb Conley? 260? Yeah, we'll put him on. Juice Robinson and Pete Dunne versus Matt Cage and Caleb Conley. And then maybe one more women's match? Oh, God. Yeah, okay. You know, this is why I have storylines. I actually should be checking out my storylines. Herpaderp. I'm stupid. Okay. So we got the big Otamatonga thing, the Hall versus Thomas match. We need to do Hojo versus Havoc. Kairi Hojo versus Jessica Havoc. So we're at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 matches, which is probably more than enough. Heavyweight title matches there. Women's title match is there. Redman and Amasis is there. Sherman versus Carino and Castle was definitely one I was wanting to do. Actually, we'll take the Juice Robinson and Pete Dunne versus Caleb Conley. Well, shit, this is a lot of matches to pack in. What have I been doing for the Amasis versus Redman deal? That might be the thing that gets cut. Because we've been working on the other one. So Redman and Amasis. This has got Sherman versus Carino and Castle. So, but we also have been... Oh man, this is... this is insane. Let me think. Should I do 7 matches? Or no, I'm already doing 7 matches. Should I do 8? Okay, we'll pencil in the 8th for Mark Sherman versus... So we did Colby Carino. So we'll do Mark Sherman versus Dalton Castle. And that'll probably be pre-show. We'll actually have a pre-show match. Considering I don't think Mark Sherman is too... Okay, he's an upper mid-carder. And Dalton Castle is a mid-carder. So we'll see. So I've got a bit of a card set up. I may actually do the Sherman versus Castle match now, and then I'll do some sort of angle with them at the actual event. So let's do Sherman, Carino, Castle segment. So that way we don't have to have them in an actual match. We can do the actual match here. So we'll actually start off the night with that. After the promo deal, of course. So Mark Sherman and Dalton Castle. Give it about 10 minutes. Sherman to win. Make it a bit of an open match. I say a decisive win. And... yeah, botched interference. Dalton Castle hit by Colby Carino. Alright. So we got that match set up here. Alright, then we can go to the back, because I don't think we've 100% laid out some of these matches. So that's what we'll do. So Kairi Hojo doesn't need to be here right now, because we're just going to make this backstage segment. Let's see. All right. So let's do Evie, Jessica Havoc, and Soo Young. That's how it was.
Evie confronts Havoc and
Young backstage.
Lay down challenge for
end of the road.
Accept.
Hang on. Evie confronts Havoc and I'm trying to shorten this as much as possible so I remember. Sue backstage. Challenge for end of the road. They accept and
beat down.
Beat
her down as
a message. Boom. Perfect. She goes there, lays down the challenge, and they're like, cool, send this message to Kairi for us. And then just beat the shit out of her. And I actually think I'm going to change that main match to... I think I might actually change this real quick. Now, okay. So we'll do... Let's do Kairi Hojo and Evie versus Jessica Havoc and Soo Young. Boom. Okay, so what we got left here? We're gonna do, let's see, we'll just do a backstage segment real quick with Alex Reynolds, unscripted.
Backstage, coming a promo on tonight's main event.
Cool. 3 minutes. Enough time. Alright, so I guess that leads us to another match. Let's see some of the females. And more so the cheaper females. Like, say, Crazy Mary and... I think I did Crazy Mary last time. Or against Scarlet. Or no, there was Evie and Scarlet. So we'll do... Crazy Mary and Kimberly. My god, they literally... Funny enough, they literally just fought last month at Shimmer in this game. That is amazing. And then, of course, a bunch of times at Shine over the course of the year. That is amazing. They already had a one-on-one match last month at Shimmer. My assumption is if they're paired this often with each other. Actually, we'll see that. What are they at? Average rating D-, highest rating D. Okay. Seem like they'll have a decent match against each other. Then again, that's Shine, so we'll see. We'll give them, you know, give them about 12 minutes. we'll make it Kimberly, but we're going to make Crazy Mary. We're going to keep her strong. Open match. And how about a flash pinfall victory? Because I'm thinking one of the previous things I did featured them. And I'm trying to remember what the hell it was. Just gonna have defeat Kairi Hojo and Sherman introduces. I know I did something with her. Oh, there we go. Havoc and Young are backstage. Beat down Crazy Mary. Oh shit. Evie was the. I'm stupid. I just realized that. God damn it. Evie's the one with Mio, isn't she? I got that far in and completely forgot about that. Herp a derp. Jesus. I'm screwing this whole thing up. Alright. Cool. So, Kairi Hojo. Crazy Mary Dobson. Alright, now that I'm not retarded anymore, or at least for the time being, we're gonna change this match up. Yeah, we're gonna change this match up while we're at it. Because I want to give Evie something to do right now. I may actually change this again. You know what? I'll spend a little extra money to do this. So we'll do Kimberly. We're going to keep Evie strong. It's going to be an open match. Let's do a DQ finish, outside interference, and it's going to be Evie attacked by Dash Chisako. So this is probably going to spend a little more money than I'd like to, but that's fine. For the sake of this, okay, let me make sure. Let me change that. Evie versus Kimberly. Kimberly's the victor, Evie to be kept strong. And now we're in a completely different realm of people who haven't really faced each other. So, cool. It works. Alright. So, we will use that. Marty Scurll, unscripted. Grabs the mic after the match. They accept the title match. He's on. All right, let me. Girl grabs a mic and claim they accept the title match, and Mio's blood is on Evie's hands. Cool. . 59%, that's fine. Well, we'll get some more matches in here. Alright, I need to see something real quick, because I know. Okay, the Big O and Paul Burchill definitely both know how to talk, so we're going to give them both a microphone and make this work. I like that, actually. So, the Big O. Let me see. Yeah, we could take the script off. Why not? We'll see. To destroy. How about that? Toss him out of the building. The Big O's backstage. He's ready to destroy Burchill and toss him out the building. Da, 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 da. Paul Burchill. Let's see. What will he claim exactly? I don't know. I forget. Would this Paul Burchill still do the curb stomp? We'll make it happen. We'll be curb stomped. Yeah, Paul Burchill's version of the curb stomp was great. So we'll give that 15 minutes. Okay, so I'm sure Burchill won't like this, but Big O's the victor. We're going to keep Paul Burchill strong. Open match. Let's see, what else do we have here? Let's see. Let's have it be a decisive finish that's a kayfabe injury stoppage. So that writes Paul Burchill out of the next week's event. And then we can use him outside of wrestling roles, doing something else. We'll figure out something else he can do. Cool. Let's see here. Actually, let me see. We're going to protect the Big O. There we go. Alright, so we're at the 65-minute mark. What else can we work our way into? Alright, let's do... Let's do this one. Let's do 1v1 call-out, challenge accepted. Very basic. Joel Redman, after after the last show, very not happy at Amasis. We don't need anything too crazy, so we'll just leave it at that. Last show... Challenges, masses for end of the road. Masses accepts. Let's keep it to 4 minutes. I'm just realizing, like, oh, they don't. Neither one of them really have much of the mic skills to pull that off. So, all right. So that gives us. Two of our shows for sure lined up, or two of our matches, no, three. So we got one, two, we got three, four? I think we got four of our matches definitely lined up for sure. One's a throwaway anyway, basically. So... And I may change that tag match anyway. I'm trying to see what else I need to be doing. Okay. So we're doing... Cody Hall, Tadarius Thomas. So we need something with the both of them. And... Overness is not something I should be using. So we'll just move down this way. And we'll pretend it's... We'll take one of these and pretend it's a thing. So, Cody Hall, Tadarius Thomas, Eric Bischoff. I know he doesn't want to work with a script, but for the sake of Hall and Thomas, I think we're going to keep one on him. I'm sure he won't be thrilled about it, but... oh God, what's the word? Mediates, that's what it was. Contract signing
of Hall versus
Thomas. We can just give that like 8 minutes. Yeah, sorry, Eric. Alright, let's throw a couple of cheap guys in this match. Who's some cheap guys I can throw in? Alright, so I know Yuma can be one. So let's find some heels that he can face for this. Let's give him Matt Cage. I don't really have anything for Matt Cage, so let's do that. I know they fought. Dude, we've been doing so much Matt Cage. It's ridiculous. To be fair, we haven't done this match since July, so I think we'll be fine. It's been 5 whole months since we've had a Matt Cage versus Yuma match. Actually, it's not since March that we've actually had a one-on-one match. Feels like we've done this 18,000 times. I think this is also technically the first time we're doing this in this version of the promotion, so I think we'll be fine. Let's make it Yuma. We're gonna keep Matt Cage strong, though. Open match. Trying to think here. If there's anything, like, specific I want to do. Let's do a count-out finish. We haven't done a count-out finish in a while. I'm sure people won't be too thrilled about that, but... it leaves it open-ended enough. I'm actually going to change the... yeah. I'm actually changing the one of the matches. I'm not going to put Juice Robinson in a match right this second. For the event, I think we might have him be a part of... the segment with Sherman, Carino, and Castle. So, let's see that. So we got that set up. So we did the Reynolds thing. Now we can do Caleb Conley. It's fine. We're going to have a long main event anyway, so I'm not too overly concerned by the dealio. It will finally be his time. There we go. 3 minutes. Good. And... I don't think I want to give him a... I'm trying to think about how I want to do this. Overness, entertainment. Okay. It's nothing really good. Just the general hype segments. I feel like I should change that. Oh well. Yeah. So, backstage segment. This is probably how I'm gonna end up like getting, I could totally do that. Scarlett Bordeaux becomes our, like, backstage girl for right now. And we'll do Alex Reynolds. Because I think that's where I'm at now with that. Scarlett Bordeaux with Afanoi Jr. on Alex Reynolds. And the main event. Main event, not main event. Herpaderp. Okay, 3 minutes. Done. And add from pre-booking. Give that a solid 20 minutes, I'd say. Yeah, that would put us right about there. Afanoi Jr. to be the victor. We're going to keep Alex Reynolds strong, as well as Caleb Konley. Open match, slow build it. Decisive finish. Alex Reynolds is furious at the booking of this match. Oh my god. I hate you sometimes, Alex Reynolds. So what happens when I have so many heels? Oh my god. Let's see. Man, I got him. He's protected. He's kept strong. You're not winning. I don't care. Oh my god, you both suck. Actually, I may have a different idea then. Hang on. I think I'm going to do a last minute change to this. We're going to keep all of them strong. It's going to be a draw. We're going to give them 25 minutes. Dude, fuck the both of you. This is how I'm going to get it from one heel to another. Why would they be pissed by a draw, for God's sakes? I mean, like, what's your popularity at? Oh, his popularity is actually quite good. Quite good. Jeez. Okay. I'm kind of seeing why they, may not be too thrilled with how this turns out. Let me see here. Does it say how much I'm paying him now? Alright, so I'm trying to change this because I don't think that my main event being a heel versus heel is going to do too hot. I need a face. Damn it. I may just have to pull the trigger on getting Afa Jr. out of this as it is. And I may have to put Alex... Because I've been wanting to put Alex Reynolds over, so we'll put Alex Reynolds over. There you go. Now, are you fuckers happy now? Jesus Christ. I hate the both of you. I do get it, though, now, because, yeah, Afa Jr. is not going to put as many asses in seats as these two are. The only downside is I just turned Shane Hollister heel. So we can't turn him face for quite some time. And it already is like, yeah. Hey, Turk, how's it going? all right. Let's see. I want to see if there's a way I can do like a stare down. I know there's like a stare down thing. Let's see this. Post-match. So there's the brawl to the back. There's the celebration. Handshake. I think I might actually do that. So we'll do... I've got an idea. Alex Reynolds, Shane Hollister. They can both take the scripts off. Gets in the ring and shakes Reynolds' hand and slaps him and runs away. Cool. There we go. I'll just take it like that. And that's how you end it. 130 minutes. Cool, cool, cool. Alright, I think we're pretty much set up now. For as much as we can do. God. Let's do this. Alright. Jake Roberts debuted his old school face gimmick. The one thing I'm not 100% in favor of is the both of them kind of not doing great. We'll have to maybe change that, I don't know. Let's see. Match lifted the crowd, Sherman and Karina. I've already got a D out of the opening contest, so that's nice. Like I said, having the road agent, having Jake Roberts there as the road agent, I think may actually help. D minus for the angles. The matches are starting to quickly become the highlights here. Alright. A D for the women's match. So that's cool. So we'll add that match there. I forgot to add the last match too. So we will do Dash Chisako Miyoshirai HPW Women's Championship. We're also going to book 2-on-2. We're doing Kairi Hojo, Crazy Mary Dobson versus Jessica Havoc and Sue Young. There we go. Yeah, I think that's how I think I have a bit of a plan that I want to do. So I just gotta remember said plan. Alright. So we've done that. Then we got the Big O thing. Paul Burchill deal. Big O versus Paul Burchill. C minus. Match lifted the crowd. That's good. Alright. So now we can use that to book Joel Redman versus Amasis. Alright. And we're also going to book... what was it? Let's see. From there, the Big O versus Tama Tonga. And that should be set there. There we go. Cody Hall, Tadarius Thomas, Eric Bischoff. So we got the official contract signing there. And this end of the year event is really shaping up now. So Cody Hall versus Tadarius Thomas. So that's 5 matches. We'll still have one more, and then a kind of a bit of a throwaway. You and Matt Cage, Caleb Conley, FNOI with Scarlett Bordeaux, E+, makes sense. C- for the main event, not bad at all. One second. Reynolds, there we go. Okay, so I had to change a couple things there. Alright, so that got a D. That wasn't too bad there. We'll see how well the show actually did. I think we did pretty good actually on the show. We'll see. So we're looking at Alex Reynolds and Shane Hollister. That's C- though, yeah. C- is great. This match will probably tank because it's 2 heels, but we'll see. Alright, so those are the 6 matches there, and we'll be adding one more match. We might as well book it now so I don't forget. 2v2. We're doing Yuma and Pete Dunne taking on Caleb Conley and Matt Cage. Cage still hasn't won in quite a while, has he? That's kind of been my point of that's kind of been like my sticking point so far. Yeah, he's been on the losing end for almost 6 months. So there we go. Alright. D+. That's certainly pretty good. Alright, so Caleb Conley, praised for a great performance. Alex Reynolds is going to be praised for a great performance. And Shane Hollister is going to be complimented. He's going to be praised too. We need all the help we can get. Happy, he was pleased, and he was happy. All right. Hopefully that might help alleviate some of the morale issues I've been having. Caleb Conley's still pissed. Eric Bischoff is not happy now. What's Eric not happy about? Alex Reynolds is much happier now, so that's good. What is he irritated about? The booking of an angle. Oh, he didn't want to be a part of it? He didn't think he was that good? I think from now on I'm just going to start putting him at, like, by himself, maybe? I don't know. We'll see. Just watch NXT TakeOver. I'm definitely going to do that when I'm at work on Friday, but then I'll definitely be watching Mania. I'll be at a friend's place, so that'll be cool. All right, so 15,000. So we spent 11,000 on workers. At this point, I'm not really too overly concerned. By the way, how many people did we draw? I didn't even notice that. We sold out 250. We sold out the keg stand for the first time ever. 15 months ago, we started off, we had 10 people show up, and here it is, the very first time we have officially sold out the keg stand. I'm going to wait a little bit, though, before we move on up somewhere else, because there's a big difference between the 250 and, like, the 500 and 1,000 and stuff like that. But we'll be looking into a bigger place, probably, at some point. Oh, shit. Cash-strapped DDT appear to have lurched into more problems. Being widely reported, they have a matter of months left to turn their financial performance around, or they will face closure. Some of the company's worried stars are already reporting. Oh, shit. DDT might be just about done. That's not good. Cool. Alright, so we got less than a week before our big end of the year show. Thursday week 2. So I'm going to do Thursday week 2 of January. Activate that. And that'll be the next Infamous show. Cool. Well, there goes DDT. They got to turn things around. I don't know if that's going to happen. All right. So I guess we're just kind of moving straight into... I think at this point, the fact that I spent $11,000 and I'm going to be spending just as much... don't save. There we go. I'm going to let that do its thing, and I'm going to go use the restroom real quick. I'll be right back. Okay. Rip. Oh, the DDT thing. Okay, 1 second. There we go. Let me sit down. All right. There we go. Just needed kind of a quick, just a breather there. Get myself situated. Alright, so we're at Thursday. Cool. Well, that's good. Okay, goal of this is not to spend every dime that I have right now. Which shouldn't be hard, because that just means don't put absolutely everybody in. okay. Man, I really need to, like, give more... I'm gonna give him more and more speeches. Just to be like, yo, man, you're fucking awesome. Let me tell you. That loyalty is pretty big. I like that loyalty deal. Or at least the fact that I'm considered very loyal. I don't know if how well that image works. Let me see. Seen within the locker room before aspects, the closer the yellow dot gets to one, more powerfully it's associated with you. Looking vertically, you can see whether you inspire fear or loyalty. So I inspire a ton of loyalty. Looking horizontally, you see whether you're having a velvet glove, being compassionate, or an iron fist, being brutally strict. Your image will change based on your actions within the game and affects how people will act when working for you. Sweet. So I have inspired loyalty. Alright, cool. No one's, like, up and leaving me right now. So that's helpful. Alright, here we go. First major show after... There we go. First major show after the anniversary show. My image is not currently sufficient to unlock either motivational speeches or psycho sermons. Alright. I was wondering how you unlock them. Let me see this. If your image gets sufficiently into the loyalty velvet glove corner of the graph above, your unlocked motivational speeches can be delivered in the locker room before monthly or annual events and can be allowed to use you. Ooh, nice. Motivate your employees into performing better by persuading them to do their best for you. So, think a bit more compassion, maybe? Or no, I bet you if I keep pulling down into the loyalty, I could probably open up the motivational speeches. I can be Paul fucking Heyman. Tell those guys, fuck you, you're wrong. Fuck you, we're right. Alright, keg stand. I like the fact that they're just booking it there all the time now. Game has learned. Alright. 2-hour show, let's do this. I'm actually going to book a pre-show match. I know. I've got an idea for it already, because I don't use them all that much. Let's see. As the faces are concerned, we haven't used Io Shirai. So, Io Shirai, and we have not really used Scarlet Bordeaux. We've used Scarlet Bordeaux. So we're using Havoc, we're using Soo Young. Scarlet we could put in a match. We could put Kimberly in a match. Should we just have Io Shirai just kill Scarlet Bordeaux? So that way I don't have to spend all that money on Kimberly. Because I know she's... You know what? Maybe it'd be worth actually trying to have that match to build people up. Yeah, fuck it. Just go for a quick squash, why not? Completely waste Io Shirai. In a match with Scarlet Bordeaux. I forgot about that. I forgot that one day that I had them around for that. The one time I brought in Io Shirai before I actually was able to sign her, she faced Scarlet Bordeaux because she was the only other female person on the roster. That's amazing. Oh boy. Yeah. Sorry. We're not trying to bury Scarlet here, but yeah, we're just gonna... I don't think she has the psychology to pull off anything other than... I was wondering if we needed to script it out beforehand, but we're not going to do that. We'll do an all-out match. Decisive win. And we'll knock this bad boy down to 8 minutes. And... let me see here. I feel like we should do like a pump people up type promo with one of the commentators. Actually, we might do both. So we might do almost like a self promo type deal. Eric Bischoff, Jake the Snake Roberts. Oh, shit, that's right. Jake Roberts. Come on, where's Jake Roberts? I can't do it. Fine. It's fine. I'll just do Eric then. I don't know why I backed out. There we go. Everyone before the show. Whoops. Welcome to everyone before the show. Promises a big show. I should put a great show, but I'd love the people to be like, big show. I knew he was going to be the big get. Okay. So, two pre-show segments. First time I think we've done that. Alright, we will start off with... oh, great. I accidentally booked for Infamous. Move booking to end of the road. Can I do them all? Nope. Alright. I'm stupid. There we go. Okay. So what should we start off with? Start off with the tag match. That's not much of anything to worry about. Yeah. We'll give him 9 minutes. Get your shit in. We're actually going to give Matt Cage the victory here. By Caleb Conley should be okay with that, because he's part of the winning team. We can keep Pete Dunne strong. Open match, all-out match, decisive win. There you go. Okay. I wonder how storyline-wise we've been looking. Oh, all of them are getting into the D's now, or at least a lot of them are. That helps. Dash, Eevee, Io, Marty, Neo. Okay. Okay. Trying to think about what I want to start off with these. What we want to work our way towards. I think I'll just, start off immediately with backstage segment. Doing Alex Reynolds, unscripted. Guaranteeing a win tonight. I don't know if guaranteeing is a word, actually. It doesn't feel like it should. Like it should be. I don't know. Something feels off about putting guaranteeing. Like, there's a lot of people who say guaranteeing. I just don't know if it's an actual word. And if it's spelled like that. Oh, well. Guaranteeing. Alright. Let's see here. trying to think how I want to do this. Slightly too soon to consider changing his gimmick. Alright. Last turn was recent. Okay. I want to try to use some of my lesser guys, just doing something real quick. Alright, because there's some guys I haven't quite used yet, so... Let's see here. I know there had to have been at least one person. Let's see, so that was... Okay, I'm just trying to look and see what I've got set up. Okay. He doesn't need to be on the show, but I'm just gonna put him in a dealio. Let me see here. I wonder if Jake the Snake would work in that. That'd be amazing to be able to like bring back the Snake Pit just for that. Okay. I'm just trying to rack my brain in how I want to use FNOI Jr. because he's not going to be in a match. So the least thing I can do is have him just be in a segment. I don't technically need to have him here. So, you know... yeah, I'm not going to worry about having FNOI Jr. there. It's just more money I don't need to spend. Okay, so from pre-booking, we'll set up for... okay, so we did this part of the setup for Alex Reynolds, and we'll do... Let's do... What's gonna take us a little bit of time? Let's do Redmond versus Amasis. So we'll do something with Redmond. We'll just do... backstage segment. Joel Redmond.
Backstage. Revenge on...
Amasis. And I think I might want to build to something a little bit later down the line with them. So we'll give them about 13 minutes. We're going to give Amasis the victory, but we're going to keep Joel Redmond strong. Open match. And let's do... Let's do Flash Pinfall. Cool. Alright, so we've set up for that. And I think I'm going to keep doing something after this. Between Redmond and Amasis. Because I think it might work. So, what should we set up for? All right, the big O. All right, so let's see, the big O. Talking about taking out Burchill and vows he will do the same to Tama. 2 minutes. Can Tama Tonga talk? I haven't ever heard him talk in New Japan. I didn't know. Well, we'll just not give him a mic. He'll be almost like a silent badass, kind of like Alpha Jr. Alright, Big O versus Tama Tonga. 14 minutes. Probably going to be terrible because the Big O's not all that great in-ring wise. Seth Strong. Let's see. We'll see. Oh, how do we want to play this? I think Tama Tonga will probably... Yeah. We're going to keep the Big O strong, though, and we'll work towards maybe the next event. So we'll do that. We'll make it... make it a count-out finish. Cheap win. If they want to add it. There we go. And that'll help us keep something a little bit as far as something that we can do with them later on. I think that might work, and then we'll figure out something for Tama Tonga to do later. Let's see here. Now, what else are we going to set up for? We are going to set up for... Let's get Marty Skrull. I don't know if we'll do it right this second, but we're going to do a backstage segment. Oh, you know what? We can do this thing again. Sex appeal. Manager talks to client, sex appeal times one. That's how we use them. Female empowerment. So that way she's there, but she doesn't have to talk because she doesn't know English. Degeneration Dasher backstage going over. Tonight's title match. We'll give it about 3 minutes. We still have four matches to put on. And... Okay. I think I'm going to have it work just like that right there. Or... Yeah, we're going to do this one first. We're going to give it 12 minutes. Winner is going to be Jessica Havoc. We're going to keep Kairi Hojo strong. And... Let's see here. We're going to do... Decisive win. And I'm trying to think. We're not going to do a kayfabe injury finish, but I want it to be sort of stated that I want it to be stated that perhaps Crazy Mary's not going to be there for a while. It's fine, I'll just leave it like that. And we'll book it on entertainment. See what post-match things we could do with entertainment. Let's see, Celebration version 2, Tag Celebration, how about that? Havoc and Sue celebrate as Mojo carries Crazy Mary to the back. All right. 2 minutes. We need to get it done and gone and out of here. We're already at 69 minutes. We'll give it 3. Why not? Okay. What else we got? I'm trying to get this moving and grooving. So let's do... I don't even think we'll have enough time for the... Well, you know what? What can we do with 3 guys and have it be based off entertainment and not overness or sex or menace? Okay, I'm trying to see how I want to do this. Okay. Mark Sherman, Colby Carino, and Dalton Castle. Come out. Brag about their wins over. Actually, I don't think either one of them really has actually... I don't think either one of them has won, have they? The more I think about it, the less sense this makes, because I'm pretty sure Sherman beat Castle, and then he beat Carino. So I'm going to change that up a little bit. So that, and then there's only 3 participants. So we'll do the host thing. So Mark Sherman... Colby Carino, Dalton Castle. Interviews. Castle. About their losses to him. Down. Say they quickly beat him down and leave. 7 minutes on that. Alright. So we can go up to 150 minutes, so I think we should be pretty good. So let's do Cody Hall and Tadarius Thomas for this. Shouldn't take too much time because neither one of them are all that great. Oh man, who should be the guy? Let's do Cody Hall. We want to keep Tadarius Thomas strong. I don't know what to do after this. I gotta admit that. I'm not 100% sure how I'm gonna end this between the both of them. It's gonna be an open match. I think there's a bit of a difference between the both of them where they sit on the totem pole. So we're going to make it a decisive pinfall win so he can beat him with the outsider's edge. Trying to think here. I think I want to do Tainted. Because he cheated. We're going to make it that he cheated. He hit him with a chair or something like that. Okay, so that leaves us to... Let's do the Shane Hollister thing. We haven't had Shane Hollister talk yet. Looks confident that he will win tonight. Simple enough. Don't need to make it too overcomplicated right now. Do that. And then Dash Chisako versus Mio Shirai. We're going to give him 16, about 16 minutes, maybe 18. I have faith in the both of them. Open match. We'll slow build it. Decisive pinfall finish. Alright. Women's championship is on the line. Everything seems to be pretty good right now. Okay. And, oh boy. I don't know how well this will work. I may want to try something slightly different. I'm trying to see the post-match stuff here. I want to see how... Okay. Out of my females. I need to see who I have out of my females that maybe I don't quite use. Okay, I don't really use Scarlet Bordeaux. Right now. I kind of used her... Oh, I've got an idea. Okay. Let's do... Man, I don't know how... Maybe something like that. Marnie Skrull. Io Shirai. I know that's probably going to go over like a lead balloon. Celebrating. As Io Shirai. Help aid her sister. Yeah, that'll keep it good enough as is. I do want... Okay, I need to do a write-off angle. No matter how bad it's probably going to be. I need something that might... We'll see if maybe the two Divas thing might work. Let me see. None of that really does seem to work. We need something with two of them. Oh my god. Alright, so this is not how it's supposed to be used, but I think I'm going to use it this way anyway, because I need some help with this. Because, once again, when you're working with two Japanese women, you need this to somehow work. And I think the overness and entertainment aren't going to be enough. I don't know how well the sex appeal works for both of them. You know what? I think this might work. And this is not how you use... This is not how you use sex appeal at all. Violently beats down Mio. In a heap. So she's kind of getting her ass completely kicked. We're going to move that back. So that way it's a thing where after the match, Dash basically knocks Mio Shirai out for good for right now, and then EO comes in to kind of help. All right, we're down to one more. Oh, let me see here. So we have 30 minutes to work with. I think I can make 30 minutes work. Let me see if this works to have Jake here. Nope, okay. I would have liked to have... I don't even know if I can make him the replacement ref. To hype the main event... and... I'm going to move my mic back just a bit. There we go. This is going to tip over on me. Hang on, one second. There we go. How it should have been pretty much ever since I got here. There we go. Is in the ring to hype the main event. Competitors. There we go. So just a quick hype up, as well as introducing the competitors. Add to the booking grid. We are going to do 24 minutes. Heavyweight titles on the line. We're going to give it to Alex Reynolds. Keep Shane Hollister strong. Open match. Slow build. I'm thinking a decisive win. The interference, though, Shane Hollister on Afa Inouye Jr., and that's how I use Afa Inouye Jr. Boom. And then, finally, to completely add it, to heal it up all nice and neat, Alex Reynolds celebrates post-match and goes overboard. Here. Title win. And hams it up. There we go. All 150 possible minutes have been accounted for. And I think we're ready to go. See how well this show runs. Oh, best of luck. Alright. Alright, Yoshirai, Scarlett Bordeaux. Yeah, that's about how I assumed was probably going to happen there. C minus a start. I wanted to get people hyped to start off. Yeah, seems to be lifting the crowd all nice. A D already for that. And Matt Cage finally gets a win. I feel like if I can turn him face, that he should be face. I feel like the strings of losses I've given him leading to this face deal at End of the Road... should have... Oh, I didn't quite sell out. Shit. Oh, well. Alex Reynolds hyping up his match. Joel Redman hyping up his match. Joel Redman and Massis. Massis got the roll-up. That's right. I'm trying to remember what I booked 45 minutes ago. Big O doing his thing. The Big O Tamatonga match seems to be pretty okay. Oh, that was a count-out. Okay. Still got a D. That's pretty nice. D-minus for the Marty Scurll dash Chisako deal. D-minus for that tag match. I have the dirt sheet segments on. I really like to know what didn't quite click. I don't know. Alright, then the Sue Havoc, Jessica Havoc, Sue Young deal with that. As Crazy Mary's kind of carted off. Mark Sherman hosting an interview segment. Yeah, Colby Carino, Dalton Castle. He's basically... Yeah, it degenerates into a brawl where Carino and Castle beat the crap out of him. Cody Altidarius Thomas didn't do too bad either. That's pretty good. Dirty Pin for the win. That's good. That's right. I think I said he's going to use a chair, but we can use the chair and the dirty pin. Cody Hall and Tadarius Thomas have great chemistry. Nice. So Shane Hollister seems to be working out well backstage. Dash and Mia Shirai. So that was defense number two for Dash. Match needed to be a lot shorter given who was involved. Ah, crap. Oh, well. D minus, not great. But, hey, a C minus for the sex appeal for both of them. Hey! Okay. That helped out for an angle, I guess. The angle where, this is going to be an F plus. Ready? E minus. Yeah, EO's not exactly, that insanely popular. Oh, well. I probably could have saved it for something else, but I feel like if they're going to beat down and we're going to essentially write off Mio, we needed to have EO kind of show up. Yeah, we're going to continue without creating something. The hype up. D plus, come on. Give me at least a C. A D. Damn. I think we might be able to get, like, a D at best for this show, which is about par for the course, I'd say. So, Alex Reynolds has won the Hawkeye Pro Heavyweight title after beating him by submission. Afa Jr. came in, kind of cost him the belt. Which is good, because they didn't seem to click, so we can move into Hollister versus Afa Jr. and then Reynolds versus somebody else. We'll figure it out. I don't think I really meant for Shane Hollister to be as transitional as he was, only holding it for 3 months, but I didn't really have anything, like, I don't know, Shane works, but, you know, between Alex Reynolds and Caleb Conley, I might as well put it on somebody who's known, and then the D+, I might be able to get D+ for this. Alright, a D, that's cool. Try to make him happy. Given a hug. I don't know if he'll like the hug. Alex Reynolds will be praised. And Eric Bischoff will be complimented. Happy, happy, and he seemed pleased. Instill that loyalty. Alright. So how much money do we have left after that? We have $3,000, which means I managed to use about $24,900. Youch. I figured that was probably going to happen because it's as big a show as it was. But we made a lot more money on ticket sales, so I'm not too overly worried. I think we're still going to make some good money because we're still waiting on sponsor money, which could equal just about that. We'll see how much merchandise does, as well as miscellaneous. Who knows? But hey, we managed to stay in the black. Alright. I would like to see, and we'll go to the first of the month and check out where we end up. So there we go. Get to the end of the year. We have finished the end of 2016, and we look on to 2017. Hopefully, pretty well. Stardom English account just tweeted about their pajama party series. Huh. Oh, what do you want? What do you want, game? Mia Shirai is gone from HPW, that's right. Well, it's been great, Mia. Every Wednesday starting in April. Ooh. I'm wondering, though, because who the hell are they going to put there? Because they already are using Stardom wrestlers in pajamas trying to talk in English. Okay, so it is going to be Japanese wrestlers. It's not going to be, because, like, they've been using the shit out of their American wrestlers. There's not a lot left that I would care to see in pajamas. I mean, if Santana Garrett wants to do you know, another program for Stardom World, I don't really mind. But yeah, it'd be kind of funny to see the Stardom girls try to... Them in pajamas speaking English would be great. Holy shit, alright. It's a lot. Yeah, if they have a pajamas party one with Io and Kairi Hojo, you'd see me turn into like a wrestling weeaboo. I'm pretty sure that's a thing. 27, we actually made some profit. Nice. Arisa Nakajima signed with Stardom, that's fine. Alright. Ooh. Okay. Before we run down the yearly things, quickly, I guess I should see how, because I didn't really stop for TNA. Might as well see if any of their titles changed hands. Bobby Roode, no, Lady Tapa still that. Oh no, Lady Tapa won it at the last pay-per-view. So it still hasn't really changed. Crimson is the World Heavyweight Champion? Oh, that began back in July? Why don't I remember that? Hey, Ethan Carter III finally lost his deal. Now, that was a few months back. I didn't even realize that. Sanjay Dutt's the X Division champion. Alright, WWE tables, ladders, and chairs. Let's see here. Ziggler and Cena still World Tag Team Champions. Eva Marie still the Divas Champion. Bubba Ray Dudley is the new WWE Intercontinental Champion. Kevin Owens is still the United States Champion. And Seth Rollins is still the WWE World Heavyweight Champion. Bubba Ray Dudley is the Intercontinental Champion. That is amazing. World Tag League. Hiroshi Tanahashi and Kazuchika Okada. That's not even fair for other people, man. That's not even... You put Tanahashi and Okada together as a team? That's not even fair. Red Dragon beat the Time Splitters. Ibushi and Rocky Romero defeated Goto and Shibata. Nakamura and Naito are a team? What? Defeated Shelton X Benjamin and Carl Anderson. I have so many questions. Tanahashi and Okada beat Davey Richards and AJ Styles. Shit. Red Dragon defeated Kota Ibushi and Rocky Romero. Tanahashi and Okada defeated Nakamura and Naito. I have so many questions about that Nakamura and Naito pairing. And then Tanahashi and Okada won the World Tag League by defeating Red Dragon. Which is amazing that Red Dragon got that far, though. Alright, Wrestler of the Year. Takagi. He's a Dragon Gate guy, isn't he? Yeah. Every match with Okada and Tanahashi was actually 1 second because everyone knew they stood no chance. Did the bell rings and they just like tap their hand on the mat? So Shingo Takagi is number one. Rocky Romero is number two. Chima number three. Okada four. Yoshino Yamada, Shelton Benjamin number seven. BB Hulk, Drew Gulak, Chris Hero, AJ Styles, Jesus Christ. Tanahashi, Richards, Shibata. Boy, this really feels like a poll for this really feels like a poll from Pro Wrestling Illustrated. I remember there was one year where they had, like, fans vote on, like, who's the best technical wrestler? Who's the most underrated wrestler? Who's the best wrestler in the world? And, like, Davey Richards won, like, most of the awards. It's like, he won, like, best technical wrestler. He won, like, most underrated wrestler. He won, like, wrestler of the year. It was retarded. Nakamura, Ibushi, Naito... Doi's up there now. Tozawa really, look at that. Like Takagi, like Rocky Romero, like just hop, skipped, and jumped up there, man. Yuji Nagata, Keynes, Chuck Taylor is up at 23. That is amazing. I'm too small for Chuck Taylor. Too small. Johnny Gargano, Carl Anderson, Tenzan, Trent. I haven't seen a WWE guy yet. There you go, Seth Rollins at 37. I want to know how Rocky Romero is number 2. Well, oh, probably all the Dragon Gate matches. Look at that. All them Dragon Gate matches, and then a New Japan match. That's probably why. You just go to like 2016. B plus. He's been killing it just this month alone. Dragon Gate picked up Azuka. Oh, damn. Alright. Company of the Year. Dragon Gate. Gee. Looking at the Power 500, I'm shocked that Dragon Gate won. I'm shocked. Cannot possibly believe that Dragon Gate got all of that. Oh my god. I wonder if there's a ranking system. No, it's just Dragon Gate. Team of the Year, Rocky Romero and Chima. This is the year... This is predicting the future. I await the next 9 months. This is the year of Dragon Gate, I guess. Match of the Year. Chima and Rocky Romero defeated Takagi and BB Hulk back in October at the Gate of Victory 2016. Is that like their biggest event? Can I make an assumption that that's probably their biggest event? It sounds like it. Oh, probably Final Gate, actually. Gate of Destiny, Gate of Victory. Damn. Seems like it'd be Final Gate. Maybe at the end of the year. Show of the Year, the Gate of Victory 2016. Young Wrestler of the Year. Daichi Hashimoto. Oh, not a Dragon Gate guy. He works for All Japan and Inoki. And he's loyal to Inoki. And for $1,100, he's willing to come here. Final Gate's the reset button. Dead or Alive is a bigger event. Huh. Should we bring in some Japanese men? He's virtually unknown here, but strong, very strong. Excellent performance, excellent physical. I don't think he could speak English, probably. Nope. He's dependable, he's social, he's loyal. He's a protege of Chono. He's loyalty to Muda. I'm going to at least shortlist him and consider him. Veteran Wrestler of the Year, Yuji Nagata. Fucking hell. We'll see. I mean, $1,100 is a lot to be throwing down. I need to get a good grip on... I mean, he'll probably be better than picking up Christopher Daniels, and cheaper, so we'll see. Yuji Nagata, Female Wrestler of the Year, Lufisto. Shit. It's interesting to know. What'd she do? Alright, Madison Eagles, a match with Madison Eagles. Chile Melissa, a couple of great matches with Leva Bates. Yeah, fucking Lufisto. Fucking Lufisto is Female Wrestler of the Year because of Shimmer, Queens of Combat, Wrestling Women Superstars Unleashed. Is that Are these getting big? Is that a thing? Like, okay, Shimmer's one thing. They're kind of eh. Queens of Combat, I remember, was kind of crap. And then that Women's Superstars Uncensored, I believe, is also not great. Now they're doing better than us. But still, fucking Lufisto. Most Improved Company, Noah. Well, so they're not doing terribly. Okay, good to know. Independent Wrestler of the Year is Liz Mark Jr. The fuck? Oh, it's because he's unemployed. So Independent Wrestler of the Year is... means he's completely unemployed at all. Like, not like in a big major company, but like just, yeah, he's just completely... To be fair, it kind of makes sense that maybe Liz Mark Jr. is the best guy that they that isn't signed to anybody. I also love how he's unemployed, but yet, no, we're too small for him. Manager of the Year, Paul Heyman. Yeah, I could see that being real. Announcer of the Year, Jim Ross. Is he... Okay, they don't consider him officially New Japan. Well, then again, this mod came out before that. Queens of Combat and then Chaotic Wrestling. But, yeah, Jim Ross. If Jim Ross had a gig somewhere like that... Oh, my God. Oh God, that's just great. That's oh, that's rich. Jesus Christ. Byron Saxton is color commented. What's his charisma? Bullshit. 82. Byron Saxton's charisma is set at 80 fucking 2. Fuck. Jesus Christ. Referee of the Year, Bryce Ramsburg. Yeah, that makes sense. Refereeing is great, but yeah, Bryce Ramsburg. Just, that tickles me so hard. What? Is Corey Graves not announcing anymore? This is where we find out that, like, at WrestleMania or something is when Byron Saxton has, like, his big major turn and he becomes, like, the hottest color commentator in the company. Holy shit, that is just fantastic. I love that so much. Oh my God. Alright, so we're up to a 14-1 in prestige and a 27-6 in momentum, so we're really picking up that momentum speed here. We're at a 19 even, E minus. Trying to see where we'd have to go to get to an E. Alright, so we're at a 23-1 would have to get us to E, so we're still probably at least a couple months away from that. And then 29-1 gets us to E+, and then God knows how far we'd actually have to go to get to that ever-lovely E+ importance, because I don't know if we're technically... I bet you we're still not out of the F+, are we? Oops. Hey, Evil. I was just about to be ready to be done. Oh, we're up to E- importance. That's good. Okay, so we're definitely making it. Alright, how does 29-1 get you E+? It's very odd how the grade system works. Yeah, the grade system makes it so there's... Yeah, the grade system, it just has a weird way in this game, so that you're not stuck at 50%, like, all the way through. So you're not stuck at, like, F all the way through, like, 60%. Either way, doing pretty well, made some money, despite the fact that I pissed away a lot of money in that, last month. won't have to do that for another few months, so I'll be able to make some more money on workers and everything else here soon. So that helps. I think after that, that's pretty much it for that. Yeah, so after the first of the year, we'll be looking at, I don't know, something else. I forgot I still have working agreements with some of them, and PWG doesn't like me. I wonder if I can just, like, end the relationship with PWG. See if that helps. But, yeah. I think that'll do it for right now. It definitely helps out having Jake Roberts as our road agent. That definitely helped out our grades with the most recent stuff. Keeping as much as we can out of the E's. So I'll take it. So I'll definitely do this again sometime later. I'm ending this awkwardly, but yeah. Stories. How far do we... Okay, so they're all D except for the Sherman Carino Castle thing. So that's actually really good, especially that women's title one. I'm pretty excited for that. So, yeah. Yeah, I gotta say, it's probably a really good thing I decided to put some storylines on. So, it'll probably help with our actual segments with stuff. So, yeah. Well, thanks for dropping by, everybody, in the chat, and anybody watching this on YouTube, thank you so much. That's all I'll end that, is with a nice picture of Megumin. So, thanks, guys, and I will see you later.